of course, 100 votes here in the House of Delegates on each bill, and many times the vote will be unanimous. But a single member can vote no even if that's the only vote in opposition. Today, freshman delegate Patrick McGeehan of Hancock County exercised that option. Why was he the only one to vote no?
It says no,
setting
it's
precedent.
Not right. I'm an Air Force Academy graduate. My father was too. My grandfather traversed Omaha Beach in 1944. My great-grandfather fought in the Argonne Forest. I'm telling you this right now because at 18, I took an oath to defend, support, and defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic. We need to defend the Constitution.
The very jobs and stimulate the economy through the private sector, and that's the only way to do it. Regulation in West Virginia is the biggest problem that we have right now. Because what happens? People are impoverished. We're seeing jobs leave. So they turn to government representatives. And we really want to make ourselves feel more important than what we really are. Because then we come up with legislation and hit the papers and we add and add a regulation. And what this regulation does is...
We in West Virginia have a tendency to go to government first. I think we have a little bit of a, what I call a dependency syndrome. And I kind of refer to our general outlook on things and state issues in regards to state policy as economic poverty. We need to adapt more free market type approaches to industry, business in West Virginia. And really this is not, it shouldn't be a Democrat or Republican issue. What we're really talking about is true freedom. It's immoral to coercively seize private property more and more. And that's kind of what we've been seeing here in West Virginia since really about the Great Depression era. In effect, we as legislators have allowed unchecked regulation to go about and create business cartels, and nothing more, there's not a better example than this than the Public Service Commission. That's allowed the energy sector to monopolize itself and force out competition, which hurts the working man, it hurts the consumer, it hurts everybody except those with the special monopoly privileges, of course.
And lastly, what are the top issues that you think your constituents in Hancock County should be aware of?
Well, I'm introducing a term limits bill this session. As Thomas Jefferson always pointed out, that those in power, no matter how good of a form or structure of government we have in place, will always tend to escalate their power. And it might take time. We've seen that in West Virginia with the amount of restrictions on them.
So the House did pass three bills today and sent them all over to the Senate. But none of them were by unanimous vote because Delegate Patrick McGeehan, who sits here from Hancock County, is voting no on all these bills. He doesn't like the idea of keeping control here in Charleston. He'd like more control to go back home to the counties.
It was masked as decentralization, but if you noticed, it still mandated every county to conform with central control here in Charleston. We need to send a clear message that we need to let our individual school districts come up with their own schedules, come up with their own way of doing business. And this is the only way we can make public education more competitive. And competition is really something, it's really the only way we're going to get public education back on the right track.
Freedom is directly connected with private property. Private property rights. Nothing in the Constitution goes against the right of private property. It's the fundamental pillar of Western civilization. The Constitution merely reinforces the right to private property. And that is the fundamental, not only the fundamental cornerstone of Western civilization, but the fundamental cornerstone of the American way of life. We gotta get back to that.
It would be three simple very simple, but very sacred and hallowed words that people about 230 years ago passed down to us. And these words are wisdom for the ages. They do not go away, no matter how much technology changes, no matter how much communities change, no matter how much people change. Those words are life, liberty, and property. And those words are wisdom for the ages, and that embodies, I believe, the American way of life. And that